Hi everyone, Debbie here. Thursday, the 7th of January 2021. First card is a reverse card, the Seven of Wands. A lot of cards are coming up with the wands, and the wands are about our purpose and our mission, our projects that we want to perhaps complete. They're a little bit on our bucket list, or we've got a real passion to do that. And the heart chakra color, just above our heart, there is the green of that vortex, is that color that represents your open heart, your passionate heart, your drive, your purpose in life again is so strong. And here you are with this purpose in your hands, and you've got a lot of other people who think their purpose and their idea, their project is better than yours, and so there's a bit of a battle going on. So you might be having a battle with your boss, your staff, your mum, your dad, your husband. There may be a dispute today of who thinks their idea is the best. And of course, we all come from our own point of view. So we think our idea is the best, don't we? This is in reverse. So a reverse card can mean just keep your thoughts to yourself, keep your heart yearning towards a closed little spot inside your deep, deep heart, because there's other things that can be showing up, and that's coming through with the next couple of cards, because we have this middle card, which is very much sometimes the middle card is the main focus. Feeling like we've got lots of burdens, lots of weight on our shoulders. We can't see our own way forward because we've all these are blinding us. So we're mentally exhausted from thinking about how to win those battles. So I say use your third card here, which is your cups and your heart and your feelings. Your guidance systems is your feelings, with the cups being represented in the third card, and balance. This fellow here and this girl here, they're balancing each other as this angel, the lion, brings them together for them to have the courage to be able to share their cups towards each other. This snake here, or these two snakes here, and they're the caduceus, I'm pretty sure that's how you say it, is a signal of balance and aiming for balance in your emotional state. So what I'm getting from the masculine and the feminine, the strong passion and drive and logic, from the nurturing, negotiating, softer side, balance the two together, and then you will actually, your burdens, your mental chitter chatter will fade away, because you're bringing into play what your feelings feel about this great idea that you've got in mind that you think is better than everyone else. After a while, you might have a softer approach or a different point of view. Look at it from a whole different angle, and some of these ideas that these people are mentioning may come into play. You might be able to negotiate, like the feminine, we always negotiate with our partners, with our children, aren't we? And our bosses, and that's one of the feminine traits that is so strong in today's society, and I think will take us through into the next decades as being leaders, is the fact that we can talk with each other and work things out. So numbers, we have 2, we have 10 and 7, so here we go, 10 and 7, 17, and another 2 is 19, 9 and 1, it adds up to 10 again, so we're bringing it back to the 1, the number 1. In numerology is like a new beginning. It's like you're on your own. You're the one that can make this happen, and only you. You can control the busyness of your mind and bring it back to a peaceful state by going for a walk on the beach, through nature, grab a cup of tea and go and have a sit in the backyard and just calm down, so that those feelings can come in and give you the best result and the best answer for you to move forward with your project. Have a lovely Thursday, everyone, and see you tomorrow. Bye.